Being media savvy is good. And also, I think that nowadays, if, with social networking, you are your own media as well, you know.
Yeah, I say.
If you only have 100 people following your Facebook page, it's like having a small website, isn't it? Mm. It's knowing how to get information to those people and to use your Facebook page properly. I'm sure people here know this, but say you had 1,000 people following you on Facebook, you put your next gig up there, only 200 people will see that because Facebook algorithm will not allow everyone to see that. Yeah. The more chat you have on the Facebook page, the more people there.
Yeah, it's all about engagement with social media. You know, it's no good kind of just putting up posts saying, oh yeah, we've got a gig tomorrow night in this place, or you know, we've got another single out or whatever. You know, that's just bland, it gets lost in the noise. You know, you've got to actually have a conversation with people on social media like you would in real life, you know, in a venue, and build those relationships with potential fans, because they're the ones that are going to buy your music and come to your gigs and buy your merch. You know, so you've really got to value them and treat them well online as well as offline. Is it good? Obviously, you know, is it a certain standard? But whether it's good or not means, does it make me feel something? You know, does it make me feel good? Does it make me feel sad? Does it make me feel something on a human level? Because if it doesn't, I'm just going to switch off and I'm not going to care. So that's number one. That's the first thing. That's the first hurdle you've got to get through. So it's got to come from the heart, whatever you're doing. And, you know, then they're going to ask the question, does this person have any sort of following? So, you know, those social media numbers might kind of play a part, although they're not the be-all and end-all. I'm more likely to ask, are they engaged with their fans? So looking on their social media to see if they're having conversations with their fans and if their fans are actually talking to them. Do they have a biog in place? Do they have a video showing a live performance that I can have a look at? Have they got a website? Really get your own website. Don't rely on social media channels. It's really important to have that one central space where everything comes back to you and you own it. Because social media channels come and go, and you don't own that data, and you've got no control over it, or very little control over it. You know, I think it's massively important, the idea of community, and it's one of the reasons that I got involved in forming Music in Devon Initiative, which we need for short. If you want to see what we do, go to musicindevon.org. Basically, we're building a network for musicians in the area, to support each other. So it's very much to do with this idea of building a pool of resources. So, you know, we've got people who do graphic design, you know, who maybe do sound engineering and, you know, all the aspects of what it takes these days to be an artist and to get your music out there. And it's about people kind of working together, not in a profit-making way, but in a kind of really cooperative, helpful way. Because, you know, working together means you're raising the bar for everyone.